You know, Bobby, after those stories, it's even difficult to talk about what's the rest of the world is doing out there. I mean, it's just such an ugly picture compared to the world that Ted wanted. I look at this Glenn Beck burn down. I don't know. You haven't had the opportunity to follow this in the last several weeks, I'm sure. But, I mean, every day is edging towards crazy. I mean, it more and more crazy. I mean, first of all, you know the story about Glenn Beck saying that he has firsthand knowledge that Obama has concentration camps that are being built by FEMA to house Republican conservatives. The next story is that Obama now has a secret army that he's actually building, and that the army is part of something that's been going on since Obama took office. The third story is developing into the fact that this is all centered around the idea that Obama is not going to yield his office of presidency when his time is up. And then you add to that the fact that you've got 1% of the public, probably less than, you know, substantially less than 1%, but you know, a couple million people watching this guy thinking that he's some kind of political oracle. And you wonder, how in the hell did we get here? But this story about advertisers fleeing is encouraging, but now the right wing's doing exactly what you'd expect, and that is that they're coming in with their campaign that they're going to punish any advertiser who says that he's not going to back Glenn Beck. Well, what do you make of this? I mean, I don't remember a time as crazy as this. I honestly don't. I don't just say that. You know, I just don't say that as a hyperbole promotion. I don't remember anybody quite as crazy as this guy that had, you know, besides Rush Limbaugh, but I think this guy's in a class of his own.
Well, you know, 10 years ago even, somebody who got on TV and talked about that in the way that he talks, nobody would advertise with him. Mm-hmm. I think it's encouraging that there's still some of these large corporations who are saying, okay, who have a limit, you know, ultimately, finally, who have a limit, are going to say, if there were progressives on TV, which now there's actually a couple on MSNBC, but if one of them went off in the kind of vein that he's gone off in with the kind of inflammatory rhetoric, there would be, you know, outrage. I mean, Phil Donahue criticized the war just, you know, in very sober terms, and he was fired by NBC.
You know what the next projection is with Beck? That don't take the flu, the swine flu vaccine, because there's some kind of conspiracy going on there. That's how crazy this guy is. But you still have those people that will turn it on and listen to this.
I bet you he doesn't do that, because so much of his stuff is sponsored by the pharmaceutical industry. So I bet he rethinks that.
Yeah, well, I'm just seeing the edge of that right now. That's just a call.
But speaking of right-wing hypocrisy, I know you appreciate this, and this is a small item, but that our old friend Fred Hystand, who was the general counsel for the Civil Justice Association of California, mm-hmm. which is an AstroTurf group that led the battles not just in California but across the country against for so-called tort reform to get rid of the ability for people to sue and to bring class action suits, has himself just brought a class action suit because his car was towed in front of a fast food joint. So that's again for the right wing consistency.
Yeah. Hey, let's take a quick break. We're going to be right back. We'll talk about more of those consistent stories.